Okay, welcome once again to Sami and Mathematics. We want to discuss this more like a popular demand, maximum and minimum points. Some students have asked me to discuss something. This is actually the application of differential calculus. You know, I've been on that series now, and this is an application of that. Now, what do I understand by this? Some textbooks may call it extremas. They call it extremas. Some textbooks call it local maximum and local minimum. Some call it maxima and minima. There are so many names for them, but this is okay, maximum and minimum point. And I will explain what they mean, then I will now show you steps to find that. So when we have a function, let's imagine that we have a function going this way. Let's call this y equals to f of x, f of t, for my friends that are engineers out there, you can change your x to t and feel good. This is your x axis, your independent variable axis, your y axis, and this is the origin. At this point of the function, we have this point to be the minimum, our x value here. Let's call this x1. So this is our minimum point. This point is called the minimum point. While this point here is referred to as the, can call this x1, let's call this x1, and this x2, I think that's preferable. So this is what we refer to as, so at this point I have a coordinate, and my coordinate is related to this, this is y1, so this is x1, y1, and this is x2, y2. So this is the maximum point, this is the maximum point, and this is the minimum point. So around this point, we also have what we call the point of inflection. Now, these points are also called local minimum and local maximum. But another name for them, they are also called stationary points. They are also called stationary points. So how do we find them in a function without having to graph the function? So without having to graph the function, how do you kind of predict these points? So let us go with that. So let's imagine the first point is you differentiate the function. So the first point is to differentiate the function, that y prime equals to f prime of x. That's the first step. The second step is to equate, f prime of x to zero. Equate f prime of x to zero. The third point is to solve for x, The fourth point is to differentiate again. The fourth point is to differentiate again, and that is to find y prime prime, which is d square y dx square again. Then the interesting part, is now for you to check if y prime prime of x is less than zero, x, let me call this, okay, let's use so for x, so x will give us maybe a and b. So if x, if this gives us, if it is less than zero, then we say that x equals to a is maximum point. And if this is greater than zero, we say that x equals to a is minimum point. So let's solve a question very fast. So these are the steps. This is the fifth step. So that is my own five steps to solving that. So let's solve a question. Let's have something like something very interesting. Y equals to x cubed over 3 minus 3x. Not really a scary function. So we want to find, the question is to find the stationary point, max and minimum point. So in some tests, you can be told to find a stationary point or critical point. So let's do that together in some few minutes. This, the first step is to find the y, the x. And the y, the x, please refer to my video on differentiation. I discussed that. This is going to be 3x squared over 3. This will cancel this, and this is going to be 3. So we are going to be having x squared minus 3 as our y prime. So this is x squared minus 3 over y prime. And the next step says we should equate this to 0. So let's do that. We are going to have x squared minus 3 equals to 0. And we are going to have x to be equals to plus or minus square root of 3. Now, I'll be cool with that. So this is going to give us plus or minus, you can refer to my video on quadratic equation. Solve that for you. So these are the points we have. So the next thing we do now is to solve for x. We have done that. The next thing is to differentiate again. So let's differentiate this function again. So y prime prime is 2x, just 2x. So we are going to put these 2 points, you know these 2 points is root 3 and minus root 3 into this. So we are going to have y prime prime of root 3 is going to be 2 root 3, which is positive. So it means that root 3 is minimum point. Minimum point. Finally, y prime prime of minus root 3 is going to give us minus 2 root 3, and that is less than 0, and that is, shows that minus root 3 is maximum point. You can also equate this to 0 and also find the equate this to 0 and find the point of inflection, which is going to be 0 also. So this is just a simple way you can find the maximum and minimum point of a function. You can always email me questions and we'll solve many more questions. Thank you. And remember to share. Please press the subscribe button.